Namaskar friends, this is NJ, your host on this channel. In this video, we will have our discussion on looking at the distinctive signs of a relationship-oriented or relationship-driven personality. Because friends, right now in the transit, not only a lot of the planets are in strong dignity, but over and above that, Venus is also right now in a very strong dignity. It's a Friday today when I'm uploading this video, recording this video. So I just thought let's have our quick discussion on some important concept of relationship or marriage only. So now friends, in the past, definitely we have talked a lot on different signs of compatibility, how to see and how to do a marriage compatibility on your own and different kind of outcomes in relationship, where we have also included divisional charts as well. But many times friends, what happen is that we are not even able to come to this terms that whatsoever indication we see in our chart, that is somehow a kind of an indication of that sort of accumulated karma which needs to be experienced in this lifetime. So somehow friends, because our parents, our siblings are something which we get as per our birth only. But when we talk about the matters of the relationship over there, we tend to have a sort of a free will. Now friends, whenever we talk about on the notion of the free will and destiny, so like the way a lot many eminent and enlightened saints have described that in a very simplistic terms, that all of your actions taken today become a part of your destiny tomorrow. Like there could be three different kinds of karma, like Sanchit karma, where whatsoever actions you have done or your soul has accumulated that from past so many lifetimes, which needs to be born, which needs to be endured in this lifetime. So those are the Sanchit karma. Then we talk about the Prarabdha, which in a way, which are all those karmas which may or may not fructify in this lifetime. And agami karma is something which we are all the time doing. But friends, when we talk about destiny perspective only, so you can understand it in a way that destiny just create those circumstances and environment over which you will do or you will face your karma. Like the way friends, it has been explained in a very beautiful way by Shri Shri Ravi Shankar ji, that you can see your destiny as your height and your free will as your weight. So the point which I'm trying to say over here is that friends, like specifically in the matters of relationship, just looking at someone's chart in a very snapshot way, you can get to know that whether this person is relationship oriented or not. Do you have those signs that you are willing to share a part, a portion of your life with another human being or not? So all those signs of dignity and growth and encouragement and cooperation through companionship. So that is something which we will try to understand over here in this video. So now friends, I will not tell you all that traditional approach which we might have discussed in the past couple of other videos. Here I will just try to summarize on two planes. One thing is, what could be those kind of very distinctive signs which could make someone relationship oriented, and what could be those distinctive signs which actually are not very harmonious towards making you a very good relationship oriented person. Now friends, like the way we say this thing, that your birth chart is something that it is a snapshot of all the accumulated karmas of your past so many lifetimes. And ever since you have been born, every single time we are doing some karma, we are doing japa, we are doing mantras, and it's a way, it is actually adding up to all that Sanchit karma of yours. So let's say for example, if in your chart, your seventh house, which is a prime house of relationship, that is heavily afflicted, but you are a kind of person who is following a very sattvic lifestyle, you are very much driven towards helping needy people, and you are actually following the righteous path. So trust me friends, you can actually, up to an extent, you can actually get rid of all the malefic influence or presence being found over there in your seventh house. Like the way I have already explained, the portion of destiny at the beginning of this video is that destiny is something which is going to create the circumstances over which and through which you will go through and you will face the results of all of your karmas. But via seeking refuge in divinity, religious and spiritual austerity, a portion of that can be made in sync, compatible to your personality. That is something which I'm trying to explain over here. Now friends, now first let's try to understand the positive signs in a chart which can actually make someone a very relationship oriented person. So friends, when we talk about the positive aspect, now trust me, my all-time favorite is that if you will find that the ascendant lord being placed in the trine houses, ascendant lord being placed in the fifth house or in the ninth house, definitely gives someone a stature of being very divine, very righteous, very religious driven, very much driven towards the prescribed norms of the society, unless and until Rahu is not afflicting those houses. But in majority of the times, if you will find ascendant lord to be well placed in the trine houses, that can be seen as a very good sign. The second thing is that, friends, you have to see the distance between the the relationship and the distance between the ascendant lord and the seventh house lord, because friends, that is how you get to know that how your life, how your personality resonate with any sort of deep committed relationship. Friends, I always say this thing that whenever we talk about the areas or experiences of the relationship, you have to definitely look at the seventh house. Now friends, the planetary presence in the seventh house, the kind of aspect the seventh house is receiving, that is going to give you this indication, your nature of experiences within the relationship. But what direction relationship is going to take you, like in which direction relationship is going to push you, that we get to know via looking at the seventh house lord's placement. So now friends, over here I will start summarizing. When we talk about someone who's going to be very much relationship driven or oriented person, you have to see the relationship between the first house lord and the seventh house lord. Second thing is that, friends, individually you have to give attention towards Venus. Like many times people just start blindly looking at Jupiter. Definitely Jupiter is a very important planet of when we talk about blessings, when we talk about the writer's code of dharma, of marriage, institution of marriage, honoring that vows which you have taken in the relationship. But specifically, friends, in these days where there's so much of the liberty, freedom, and people have their own degree and sense of their individuality and their individual freedom and all of that, so Venus becomes very important. Like whether you have that urge or need of the presence of another person within your life or not. So that notion of love, because these days, friends, unless and until the love aspect is lacking in the relationship, you might not be able to sustain a relationship for long term. So because of which, friends, you have to give attention towards the dignity and the strength of Venus in a person's chart. The third thing is that, friends, now definitely when we talk about the seventh house lord, that also plays a very pivotal role. Now let's say, for example, if you will find that seventh house lord is well placed, like the best combination could be that if it is placed in the ninth house, if it is placed in the 10th house, 11th house, or third house, or even the fourth house or the fifth house, that can be seen as a very good sign. That is going to give us this indication that the marriage or matrimonial course will definitely uplift the course of your life. So that could be seen as one of the very good indication. Now friends, when we talk about the role of the nodes and the luminaries, so definitely, friends, they also play a very pivotal role. Like specifically when I talk about the a person being a relationship oriented person or not, so for that you have to give attention towards the psychological state of the person. So more than the ascendant, you have to give attention towards the dignity of the moon in the chart. Now let's say, for example, if moon is conjunct with Jupiter, moon is sitting in the zodiac signs of the benefic planets, like moon being placed in its own sign, or moon being placed in the signs of Mercury like Gemini or Virgo, or being placed in Jupiter signs or the Venus in signs, so that can be seen as a very good sign. Now over and above that, friends, if you will find that moon is also conjunct with benefic planets, so that is definitely going to make you a very relationship oriented or driven person. But let's say, for example, friends, if you will find that moon is conjunct with Mars, or moon is conjunct with Saturn, so these are the kind of influence which can actually make you very rough, very raw, or kind of very much repellent towards the compatibility quotient within the marriage or within the relationship. Now, definitely, friends, because the influence of Mars in the moon can actually make you very wealthy person, but from the perspective of being adjustable in relationship, so Mars is not a very harmonious planet for that. And friends, when we talk about Saturnian influence, so Saturnian influence can actually make you very melancholy, very aloof or recluse in the relationship, which is also not considered as a very good sign. And the influence of even the nodes is not considered as very auspicious. Like for example, if you will find that moon being conjunct with Rahu, that can actually create a lot of illusion or high sense of desires or high sense of individuality. And the conjunction of Ketu with the moon can actually give you very psychic degree or sense of a personality which might not be very harmonious for the sustenance of the relationship. Now friends, these are the few distinctive signs. Here I will summarize everything. Now when we talk about a person being relationship oriented person, you have to first see the overall course of the life of a native. So ascendant lord being very well placed, like for example, the best win-win situation is that ascendant lord is placed in the trine houses, which can be considered as a very good sign. Or even ascendant lord being placed in the 11th house is also considered as a very good sign, because that in a way makes you a very sociable person. Now friends, when we talk about the 7th house, so if you will find that 7th house lord, comparing its placement with the ascendant lord, it is not creating a 6-8 combination, Shadashtak dosha which we call it. So that will be considered as a very positive sign, because friends, even at the time of the compatibility, like the so-called the Bhakut compatibility, what we do is that we see the compatibility from the moon's perspective. Like let's say for example friends, if you will find that the natal moon signs in both the two prospective people's charts, if you will find that in both of the charts moon is being placed in the same sign, which is a very good sign. Like unless and until the nakshatra is not same, or even the nakshatra charan is not same, so that will be a positive scenario. Next is if you will find the alignment between two people's moon signs in their chart is of 2 and 12, that is not considered as an auspicious sign. That in one person's chart moon is placed in Gemini, in another person's chart moon is placed in Taurus, so this 2-12 combination is not considered as auspicious. 3-11 is considered as a very good sign. Even friends, the 4-10 combination is also considered as auspicious. Now a 5-9 combination, which in a way is considered as auspicious, but from the Bhakut perspective, this can actually give concerns pertaining to the progeny. So even 5-9 combination from the moon signs is not considered as a very auspicious alignment. And friends, 6-8 distance is generally considered as the worst. So these are the few things friends which you have to give attention towards. And specifically friends, now if you come from that part of the society or community that you still follow the institution of the joint families and everything, so then in those kind of scenarios it also becomes very important that whomsoever person's chart you are considering, what is the state and dignity of the second house lord, second house and the fourth house, and the fourth house lord in the chart of that native, because that is going to give you this indication whether this person is family oriented or not. Like for you, your whole family might be the whole world to you, but the person you are going to get in contact with, or the person who is going to come or enter your life as a spouse, as a partner, if that person's chart is not resonating on that plane, then it might create resistance or friction in the relationship. Because friends, even if I were to share certain examples with you, so like for example, there is a very good friend of mine. In his case, he has got a Virgo rising sign. So in his chart, his 7th house lord, which becomes Jupiter, it is placed in the 5th house. It is debilitated. That is one red flag. Second red flag is that in his case, in his 8th house, his Rahu is also conjunct with Venus. But the saving grace in his matrimonial life turned out to be that in his chart, his 2nd house, in his 2nd house, his Saturn is exalted, being conjunct with Ketu over there. And not only it is giving rise to the cancellation of the debilitation of the Jupiter, but over and above that, this is a kind of person who has been very much traditional, very much driven towards the following all the religious duties, like keeping the fasting and vrat and doing donation and everything. So 2nd house, which is a prime house of your roots, of your tradition, of your values. So only because of that, he might have been born with a kind of a afflicted yoga or vulnerable red flag zone in his chart. But because of the duties and the kind of the spiritual austerities he has been performing throughout his life, somehow he remained lucky in actually mitigating the negative afflicted side of his this kind of yoga which is getting formed in his seventh house. Now friends, there is one more vulnerable chart which I remember. In this person's case, he has a Gemini rising with his ascendant being in the Ardra Nakshatra. And not only that, even in his case, his moon is also placed right over there in the first house in the same Ardra Nakshatra. In the seventh house, if you will look at the seventh house Lord being Jupiter, it is placed in the eighth house, heavily afflicted, debilitated over there. But again, friends, in his case as well, because of the strong dignity of the Saturn in his case, somehow his the traditional norms, you call it the support of the family and his own choices, he tend to remain lucky in mitigating the affliction of the matrimonial life's vulnerability. Now friends, there is one more chart which I remember. This was the chart of one of the lady. I still remember we went through this palmistry course at Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan back in Delhi. So in her chart, she was had a Leo rising and her ascendant Lord being Sun was exalted in the ninth house conjunct with Mercury. Her Venus was very well placed in the 10th house. That is again a very good sign. Her Saturn being the 7th house Lord was well placed in the 6th house. It was also conjunct with Ketu. Jupiter was placed in the 7th house. So these are the friends few sort of alignments which not only make you a very sociable personality, very happy-go-lucky personality, but also you have this provision that you give space for the presence and companionship within your life. And trust me friends, I still remember the chart of that lady. Why I brought that chart in this discussion, because she told me this thing, that because of the marriage and because of the strong dignity of her planets, irrespective of the fact that her husband did not have that strong dignity of the planets in his chart, but just because of the support which this lady's planetary alignment was giving her husband also started doing very good post-marriage. So this is how, friends, just while looking at a first cursory sight at someone's chart, you can get to know that whether a person is relationship oriented or not. So the summary of this discussion is that your ascendant Lord's dignity in the chart is going to tell about your life. The planetary presence in the seventh house is going to tell about your experiences within the relationship, the direction of your matrimonial course which it is going to grant or provide to your life is going to be determined while looking at the seventh house Lord's placement in your chart. Venus is a planet which needs to be strong emphasis and dignity, because that is going to create those energies of the urge and need of companionship, appreciation of the presence of another person within your life. And over and above that, friends, Jupiter also becomes very important, because somehow Jupiter gives us prosperity, happiness and success through relationship. Lastly, friends, when we talk about the involvement of the nodes or when we talk about the malefic planets, so they are can be considered as the biggest obstruction in the relationship, because somehow they can make someone adamant, they can actually create some sort of illusionary energy which is the domain of Rahu and Ketu, which might not be very easy to decode. Then you have to get into the deeper aspect of doing the matrimonial compatibility or looking at the activated dashas or not. But individually, benefic presence in the chart and benefic presence on the moon is something which actually makes someone very relationship oriented. So this is something, friends, which I wanted to say as a part of my inputs on this concept of relationship and compatibility or being a relationship oriented person or not. For furthermore updates and notifications on the divine science of Vedic astrology, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page. Dhanyavad.